Slayer, 7 Days to Die with Silver Blade.
damn it, son of a... Ouch.
You must remember to...
Hey, Miles Power!
Don't you feel foolish?
Greetings, minion survivalists. Hey, I'm doing an intro over here. Greetings, minion survivalists and fellow gamers. This is Silver Blade playing 7 Days to Die. Alpha 4, 15.1. And this is episode 69, man. I had to write that one down. So let's go and loot the body. Alright, so in this episode, we are going to make a quick and daring trip to the trader, hopefully before he closes. This is day 36, and pretty much most of the day has gone by since the horde arrived on day 35. I pretty much spent the day doing repairs, getting stuff melted down in the forge, and all that goodness. And that nice, pretty sky. And, that's pretty much where I left off. Can we get a splody head? Oh, I thought I timed it right. And I thought wrong. Alrighty. But, yeah, just did some repairs and getting stuff together. And not much more than that, really. So you're not really missing much. It was just grunt work. Lady, will you splody head? Yeah. Oh, yeah. And she had sandwiches. Oh, joy. Anywho, welcome to a new week of madness. God only knows where things will lead. And if you've been... What? Okay, that was uncomfortable. If you've been following my channel, you may have noticed that I have done my first live stream of the year. Actually, it's more like first live stream in a year.
Take your time.
Don't mind if I do. And it went by pretty well, in my opinion. I think you guys that were there, Pamela Goodman, Bloodbane, Steelheart, Sid Charlie, I feel like I'm forgetting somebody, and I feel bad if I did, but we all played, the Jackbox Games 3 with Murder Trivia Party and what was it? Quiplash 2. Loads of fun. Little nuggets of me.
Just to let you folks know, the Trader Joel's will be closing soon.
Aw, shit. That ain't good. Well, we gotta book ass to get this stuff out of the inventory. So I will shut up so I can focus on this and then resume my mouth babble when we're kicked out of this place. And we're getting rich while doing it. But I need certain goods. Okay. Alright, you're not interested. Bummer. That's fine, I can scrap those. Everything else I'll keep. Alright, let's just try to bum rush through this. Come on, come on, come on. I hate being rushed. I really do. none of that. Really don't need any of that. Bummer. He doesn't have any of that miracle goop for steel reinforcing. Tasting and brewing it. Yeah, I already know that. Oh, come on. Shit. And it made me fire around. Not cool, Joel. Not cool. You bastard. Will it explode your head? No. So anyways, about the live stream, we had a good time. Lasted a little bit longer than I was hoping to, because usually about 11:30-ish, sometime between 11:30 and 11:45 at night, I have to like close things down to do my nightly bookkeeping work. And it's running time. And I think I've got this episode all messed up in terms of timing. Anyways, with the live stream, it is what it is. A lot of other YouTubers, close friends of mine included, will play a game and people will watch. And that's well and good. I mean, what's that? 99% of all YouTubers do that. And there ain't nothing wrong with it. Not saying there is. But I don't know. I record episodes to last all week, plus the multiplayer for the weekends. And that's a lot of just watching me dick around. And the way I look at things, you know, you guys, especially those of you guys that watch me regularly, you know who you are. You know, you guys watch me dick around, and it just seems like, you know, your loyalty should be rewarded by being able to play with me. You know, join in. And it's part of, you know, adding to the community when you can interact with them in that way. And not every YouTuber or even Twitch streamer really does that. And that's kind of what I want to do. You know, be able to play with you guys, interact with you guys. Because there's only certain hours that I can play games with other people. And then there's times where it's just, I don't want to play with anybody. I just want to have my me time, which sounds kind of bad, but really it's just, you know, it's my way of relaxing and unwinding, and I can sit here and collect my thoughts and, you know, just unwind from the work that I do. And so, you know, to be able to have some time dedicated to playing with you guys is my cheap ass way of showing my appreciation of you guys who support me and watch my channel on the regular or even slightly irregular. And it just, you know, it's just a lot of fun. And maybe deposit these and those and those. There we go. All right, so let's look things over out here. Just so you guys know, I talk about live streaming. That's going to be, I want it to be a semi-regular thing. I'm kind of leaning towards doing live streams on like Wednesday nights, possibly. Give or take 9 o'clock p.m. It might be subject to change, just depending on where things are, because my online work kind of comes first. I mean, you can't, you know, if you don't eat your meat, you can't have any pudding. Well, if you can't do, if you don't get your work done, you can't play games. It's adulting 101, right? So, that's kind of the idea there. So, once I get my work done on Wednesday nights, I'm thinking about it. It isn't carved in stone yet. That I'll be doing regular live streams. Because this way I can watch Midnight Designers live streams on Tuesday nights and Thursday nights, not miss Hal's live stream on Friday nights, have Saturday night open for when Hal and Sharky and I do our multiplayer, plus it gives me Sunday night, well actually it gives me after live streaming, Hal's live stream on Friday, because I record my weekly episodes on Thursday night, Friday morning, I can render my videos after Hal's live stream, upload them like Saturday or Sunday, and then like Monday, something goes on Monday. Monday I can't do much. I might do something, but it depends. It's a very wishy-washy kind of time schedule there. But yeah, Wednesday seemed like the only night that was truly available for doing a live stream, and so I might be doing it regularly on that night. And yes, the games that I'll be playing will mostly be like the Jackbox games, or if I can find the website again, there was a website that did a version of Cards Against Humanity, which is like my kind of humor. And so I might do something like that. From time to time, I might do like Mech Warrior Online, World of Tanks, World of Warships, Armored Warfare. So if you guys are interested in playing with me in those games, you might want to download them. They're free to play, so it doesn't cost you to get the game. You just go to like MWO.com, I think it is, for Mech Warrior Online. World of Tanks, I think it's wargaming.net. And that'll get you World of Tanks and World of Warships and even World of Warplanes, but you know, that game isn't all that great. And then Armored Warfare, I think it's armoredwarfare.com, or I can't think of the name that makes it. But you can Google search Armored Warfare and be able to download it from the website and get that installed. It takes a long time and a good chunk of hard drive space to install those games. So that's something you might want to consider. Whereas with the Jackbox games, I've purchased it. All you have to really do is watch the live stream for, you know, the answers and the commentary from the game itself and mine. And then you would need an open browser to go to jackbox.tv. You enter in your name and then the room code that would be viewed in my stream, and then you can join along. If a game's already running and you get in late, you can still enter in, but you'd be part of the audience. So that's part of the fun of that game, is if there's more than 8 people watching and wanting to play, well, more than 8 people can play. It's just the game caps the active players at 8, I believe. So, you know, there's that. But it'll be an interactive live streams. Now, rarely I might play a game like 7 Days to Die or Empyrean or something like that. Rarely I'll do that during a live stream. But for the most part, when I do a live stream, you guys will be able to play right along with me. And that's kind of like my way of saying thank you guys for watching me on the regular basis and commenting and supporting me, you know, in doing YouTube, really. You know, it's really the only way I can afford to properly thank you guys back is just by interacting with you guys. And it's a lot of fun. Anyways, I mean, that's what my channel is all about, is having fun and being able to directly share it with you in real time, or at least 30 seconds off from real time. It's just about the best way I can do it, really. Might as well go through here and see if any of these have respawned. And this episode is going to be kind of shit sloppy because I did poorly time it. Originally, I was intending to do a loot run of the bookstore and go a long way about it. But since it's dark and it's a lot of running involved, I'll probably be doing that in tomorrow's episode. Meanwhile, I'm going to get some oxygen. And going back down. But anyway, yeah, I had a good deal of fun with you guys. I hope you guys had fun as well. It definitely seemed like you guys did. And I hope to make that a regular occurrence. Again, it's kind of tentative, but if you follow my Twitter feed, at Silverblade Dag, D-A-G-G, if you follow my Twitter feed, you'll know about an hour in advance of when I go live with the live stream stuff. And, yeah. Everything's empty. Great. Actually, I want to go up here. There, Gurnet. Up all the way. There you go. Keep moving, Hoss. I can't really think of anything else to say. Except I don't have the materials to repair these, but oh well. And empty Mountman chest. Great. And hop up there. Ah! Almost went overdone it. In a bad way. Let me think, what else? Brain fart. Oh, make sure you guys check out my good buddy, my inspiration for getting into YouTube, Midnight Designer. Check out his channel, but furthermore, join us in his live streams. From what I understand, Mrs. Designer has given the good man permission to go pretty much full time into YouTubing, and he's a great guy. And again, like I said, he's a guy that inspired me to get into this, so you know, you can either thank him or blame him, depends on your perspective. But do check out his channel and help him out, you know, if he's trying to make this a full-time thing. I really wish him a great deal of success, because I'd like to make this a full-time thing. I kind of am doing it full-time since I don't really have a job, but you know, I don't have a wife and kids, a mortgage, two cars, and 2.5 pets to feed and pay for and all that. And it looks like this needs a tweaking. Actually, let's get some more clay going here. But yeah, check out Midnight Designer's page. Give them lots of digital love, and he will reward you with splody heads and cool dad jokes. And he's just a great guy and a great member of the community, and more worth your eyeballs than I am worth your eyeballs. Not to say I'm chopped liver or nothing, but you know, I wouldn't be doing this if it wasn't by watching him and being inspired by the awesomeness that is the Midnight Designer. Got a little gushy there, didn't I? I need some 7.62s because I made the wrong ammo off camera. That ain't making me squat. Yeah. Okay, so we really haven't done a whole hell of a lot this episode, to be honest with you. And I apologize for not actually getting you top-notch, pulse-pounding action in this episode. That's just kind of the nature of the beast. Sometimes things go really, really intense, and sometimes things are just me trying hard. Trying harder than those guys crawling on their belly. Right? And I left hatches open. You know the old joke, or the old saying, were you raised in a barn? Well, and this is a true story too. Growing up, my house was actually shaped like a barn. It wasn't actually a barn, although sometimes you probably couldn't know it based on the amount of pets we had, cats and dogs and such. But it truly was shaped like a barn. And you'd think that I would still know to shut a door behind me. Well, you'd be wrong. Alright, well, like I said, this episode really wasn't too terribly exciting, although I gotta say that the view of the moon and the sky seems like it's gotten better for some reason. It looks sharper. Very cool either way. See my little ADD moment. But on a positive note, constructive note even, running around like this has reminded me of the things I need to work on in future episodes, or perhaps even off camera, to take care of all business. And I think we can at least get a little bit of it started, so at least I could feel like I've recorded something somewhat productive. Although I can't vouch for its entertainment value. So do bear with. Nighttime wood chopping. This can't be boring, right? Right? I can already feel the subscriber count dropping. Eh, we all have those weak moments where things just don't work out quite right. But we make do with what we got. And make up for it later, right? Yay, wood. I'm surprised all this noise has not drawn any zombies in. But give it time. So one of the things I want to do this week, besides replacing all the damaged defenses on the this side of the canyon, I want to get a proper farm put into place for the edibles, as well as for this tree farm. I'm also thinking that we're going to have to do loot runs, and I'm thinking tomorrow's episode... Whoops. Yeah, tomorrow's episode, we're going to do a loot run to Gravestown, and that's going to be a passing loot run to get all the way up to the bookstore that is north of Gravestown and just... west of the Working Stiff. And dink. Because my main need right now is a mini bike. Because without that kind of mobility, going around on my hands and feet to try to get stuff and get anywhere, it's just very slow and laborious progress. I think I got just about every other schematic and book. I can't think of any ones that I don't have right offhand, but that Mini Bike for Dumb Shits is the number one book that's in high demand that I do not have. And like a Pokemon, I got to read them all. Or catch them all, then read them. Whatever. Another thing I just realized and did not mention earlier that I'm going to probably catch hell for not mentioning, but not only should you be watching Midnight Designer, and you should be watching Midnight Designer, as like, you know, it's 7 days to Die if you're interested in the game. If the first person you're watching is not Midnight Designer, then hang your head in shame. Just kidding. But yeah, you gotta watch Midnight Designer, you gotta watch Games for Kicks, you gotta watch Endems, who is finally returned to us after a long protracted absence, and I, for one, am particularly glad he's back. It's like the Broken Ankle crew, as I recall it from when I first started out, is now back again. You know, it's like the whole crew from Tombstone, you know? Don't know which one's Doc Holliday, but he's in there. But, you know, Endems is back. He also, you know, so check out his channel. You should also be watching Hal's channel, Haladmer, Haladmer. And you should be watching Sharky's channel as well. And hopefully he's getting regular content together for you. now that he's got his recording set up pretty much in order. So you gotta watch him, help him out, and help him build his channel. And there's Aussie Madam, there's Lynn Voyager, Sid Charlie. They're all, the links for them should be in the description box below, and if they're not, they're, if you go to my main channel page, on the right hand of the screen is a list of YouTubers that I watch and people that I like that have YouTube channels. Go check their channels out, subscribe to them, tell them Silver Blade sent you. You know, they're not paying me to plug their channels or give them shout-outs. It's just, they're great people. I like supporting great people, especially those that have helped me out or have inspired me in some way, and I hope that they can do the same for you as they have for me. And, you know, they're just deserving of people's attention, and in my opinion, more so than I am. So do check them out and subscribe and lavish them in the digital love, as it were. Get it all pixelatedly sticky and gooey and nasty, and now that you're sick to your stomach, keep an eye out on my Twitter feed for my live streams. Hopefully I'll be doing them regularly, like every Wednesday night, barring unforeseen circumstances, but I'll try to keep up with that. So, before I finish, I do like to apologize for this episode not being super spectacular and me rambling on about things not related to this episode, and that this episode's been boring or just not useful. I'm overheating. Go figure. But hopefully I will make up for it with the four episodes of 7 Days to Die that come out further into this week. So, hopefully I make up for it. So anyways, guys, thank you so much for watching and tolerating my bullshit. And until next time, see you later. Twitch.